Today I'll show you how to do a really cool splash anodizing technique on titanium, up next. Okay, got my piece of titanium cleaned up off camera with acetone, and I've got my latex gloves on now so I don't transfer any skin oils to my workpiece. I've already got my titanium anodized blue, but if you're starting with a piece of bare titanium, you can follow the steps in my how to anodize titanium video to get your piece anodized to this stage. Next, we'll use nail polish to mask any parts we want to keep blue. On this knife scale, on top of the design, I also wanted the lettering to remain blue, so I painted the nail polish into the lettering, then wiped off the excess and lightly cleaned it with acetone, being careful not to remove the paint from within the letters. Next, I just flung nail polish all over the piece in a pattern that I liked, then set it aside to cure overnight. If you have lettering that you want to show like I do, you'll have to mask it off before you start to fling your paint. I forgot to do that in this clip, so off camera I had to wipe my piece down again and then cover my painted letters with a small piece of electrical tape. Then once you're done splattering your paint, you can just pull that tape off before you anodize. And now this is my piece ready to be anodized after I've pulled the tape off. At this point it can go into the anodizing bath. The next step's to connect the batteries and leads. I'm aiming for a gold color, so I'm using 6 9-volt batteries. Positive goes to the piece you're anodizing, negative goes to the piece in the bath already. If you're looking for a more in-depth, step-by-step tutorial on how to anodize, I have another video on my channel called How to Anodize Titanium. I've linked to it in this video's description and at the end of the video. In this video, we'll just kind of breeze through it all. Once you achieve the color you're looking for, you can remove it from the anodizing bath and dry your piece off. Next, you're going to want to wipe your piece down really, really well with acetone until you get all the nail polish removed. And that's how you achieve an anodized splatter pattern. Obviously, you don't need to splatter the paint. You can use this method to make any design you like. If you learned anything from this video, please take a second and hit that like button. And if you aren't subscribed to the channel yet, please consider subscribing because it really helps the channel out. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments. I try to answer each and every one of your guys' questions. I know I've talked to quite a few of you already, and I always enjoy answering questions you guys might have. Now on to the fun stuff. Wanted to do a small knife giveaway to say thank you to my subscribers on my next video. All you guys need to do to be entered into the giveaway is to be currently subscribed to the channel with notifications on, like this video, and leave a comment in this video's comment section telling me what your favorite knife is. I'll pick a winner at random out of the comments section and notify you through your comment and also announce the winner on my next video. The giveaway is for 18 and over. And if I pick you and you aren't 18 yet, we'll figure something else out. Got some other gear that I can maybe hook you up with. I did a small giveaway back around Christmas time and it worked out really well. So figured I'd try it again just as a little thank you to the subscribers. Appreciate you guys. That's all I got on this one. See you on the next one.